a pregnant staying-at-home mom by the name of Taryn. She was on Reddit, and she said that she was finding it harder and harder to get things done, especially with an active young boy in the house. So she started leaving her five-year-old home alone instead of having to drag him on a bunch of errands. She also shared that one time she even left him and ran to the mall while his lunch was in the oven, figuring that by the time it was ready that she would be home. Apparently her fiance came home early one day and found the top by himself and was furious, texting her that she was crazy and adding, "How do you not see that this is wrong?" Leaving a five-year-old unattended in the house. She was trying to go on Reddit and drag her fiance a little bit, being like, "Look at the way he's treating me. How dare he do this?" And I guess it, you know, the internet flipped on her and was like, no, you're the one leaving a five-year-old home alone. What are you, a psychopath?
With an oven on. Lord knows my oven is sketchy at best.
Some texters say, "I definitely ran to 7-Eleven across the street when my son was 9 months old. Last year we started. Kids were 13 and 11. Best thing wife and I, we can slide out for dinner and not have to take the Rugrats. My roommate leaves her son home alone a few times a week. When she runs to teach a class at the gym, he's six."
Oh, my God.
I mean, are we now in an era where the latchkey kid is far less prevalent than it used to be, when you'd have the key hidden either in your book bag or on the property somewhere? Let yourself in. Mom and dad will be home soon. I remember being left home alone.
What age, though?
Probably, I think, 10 or 11.
That's double the age of what this woman's doing.
I can't leave. I can't see it. Evan is 3.5. He's 3.5. He'll be 5 years old in a year and a half. I know he's going to make big progress by there. This is the time when they make their biggest leaps and strides. I still don't think it's going to be big enough.
Look, I got a six-year-old, right? And I probably could do this. Like, if I was zipping, like this guy said, to a 7-Eleven and I'm back in like 10 minutes.
Like, if it's across the street.
She probably won't even have moved from the spot on the couch with the iPad. She'd just be in the same spot. But you can't take that chance.
No.
You can't. You can never. Are you kidding me? What if something happened to her? What if she's like, "Oh, I want to crawl up here on top of the fridge and get some cookies," or she falls off the freaking fridge.
Look, a steak knife. I could eat this.
It's actually against the law in Maryland.
And that's it, too. I was reading that maybe, I guess, 8 years old is the law.
8 years old to be left alone. You have to be at least 8 years old.
Yeah.
And to babysit another child, you have to be at least 13.
13.
You don't even have to worry about this if you don't have kids.
It's just insanity.
Yeah, 5 years old.
And what's worse, this or the people that leave their kids sitting in the cars while they're like at a strip club or something?
Oh, cars. Yeah, at least they got home field advantage if they're stuck at home with an oven while whatever horrible Totino pizza roll bakes that's going to burn the inside of their young mouth in a car while they go and lose the college fund at Pie Gal Poker. But still sucks. Let's go to the phones, 410-338-1098. Let's go to Josh in Frederick. Josh, good morning.
Hey, good morning, fellas. How you doing?
What's up, man?
Hey, so the only crazy one that I had in recent memory was I have a seven-year-old, and we stopped at a 7-Eleven.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
We need eyes on Josh.
Oh, God, no.
Get eyes on Josh. No.
I'm sensing some bad stuff there.
Yeah, I think someone decided to hang the phone up for him because this was him leaving someone in a car while he ran inside to go do something. What's up, our old pal Whiskers?
Hey, Whiskers!
What's up, buddy?
Good morning, fellas.
You got any kids? Hey, you got kids, Whiskers?
Yeah, too many.
How many?
Mine's all grown. Their youngest is 13.
How many kids?
I mean,
you got?
Youngest is 15, 6, 17.
How many?
17.
Though? 17.
How many?
Yeah.
I got a six pack.
You got six kids?
Six or.
Damn.
Six pack.
Those
yeah.
Boys swim.
From 31 to 17.
From one woman?
Yeah, how many women?
Yeah. I wouldn't want two of them things calling my house. I'd take her out and shoot her.
Damn, Whiskers goes hard. So let me ask you, Whiskers, wise man with a tale to tell, what age were they when you're like, "Hey, dad's got to head to the feed store. You hang out here on your lonesome"?
You leave them there at 10, you know, can or so, but like you can dart out the door, do a little work, walk in, keep an eye on them.
Yeah.
But don't leave too.
No, that'll get into trouble that way.
You end up in mystery. No, they end up in mystery because they won't sit in front of the TV.
What do you think about the oven being left on?
No, you don't ever leave nothing cooking on the stove or in the stove because kids get curious and hungry when they smell the cooking.
See?
There you
we
go.
We think Whiskers is crazy. He's a smart man.
Smartest guy that calls this program.
What are you doing today?
I'm getting ready to take some horses out for a friend of mine and groom them a little bit, brush them down, and that's probably about it. The rest of the day, I'm going to do nothing.
Sounds amazing.
Whiskers,
sounds
would you amazing. Be willing for a cash exchange? I might have a boy in my house that might need a teaspoon of toughening up. If I maybe left him with you for a week, would you be willing to for a cash amount to be determined to live with an 11-year-old for a week and send him back a man?
Hey, I would groom him a little bit, but the last guy I groomed, it was pretty sad. I wouldn't discuss it in the
on the air,
but it was sad.
Hot damn, it's a deal.
I don't know what he means by that.
No idea. He definitely took a child to get a lip tattoo and gave someone their first sip of tequila. Whiskers, always love talking to you. Let's go to, Scott, this is going to speak to you. Let's talk to Shane in Westminster.
Morning, guys.
Morning.
So, you know, I'm 24. When I was a kid, you know, my parents would shoot out for a little while, do whatever they had to do, which is fine. But in today's day and age, you know, seems most parents just throw a tablet or an iPad in front of the kid, let them go. But, you know, with the whole YouTube craze going on the last few weeks about this Momo character and all that kind of, you know, jazz, it's a little different. You can't just leave your kid home with an iPad and think they won't move. You know, who knows what they're going to do while you're gone.
Yeah, they start link jumping from one weird video to the next weird video. And, you know, there's been times, thank you for the call, that I know I could have gone to the store because one of them is so zombified in that screen.
Yeah.
I could have gone furniture shopping and come back and they would have still been sitting in the same butt dent in the love seat as when I left them.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really weird thing. Like, I've gone outside and be like, hey, daddy's going to be out back picking up some sticks for, you know, a few minutes, and I'll go out back and I'll straighten up the backyard or whatever, and she's in the couch for a half hour or whatever. What's the difference?
Let's talk to Jay. He's got an angle with the stove thing. What's up, Jay?
Hey, guys. Thanks for taking my call.
Our pleasure.
So apparently when I was three, my favorite thing to do was to go downstairs, turn all the burners on, get up on a stool, and teeter over the stove, feeling the heat. So my
So you're a crazy person.
Jesus.
Exactly. So I'm really, really glad that my parents did not leave me alone because I guess my old man came down and found this. And then after that, they took all the knobs off the stove. And then I think at one point they changed the locks on my room, and then I went and swallowed a whole bottle of aspirin too. So,
oh my God! Yeah. You had like a death wish. You're trying to cook yourself and swallow a bunch of medicines?
Exactly. So anyhow, hey, I'm still alive and kicking in my 50s, so I guess my parents did the right thing.
There you go.
Right?
All right. Yeah, I posted a photo of Stella one time in our old kitchen. And people were commenting, oh, nice ghetto stove, Scott, because I didn't have any of the knobs on it. And I just responded, I'm like, I've got a toddler, you morons. You take the knobs off. Everybody knows that.
Derp.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.